Hi, it's Sleepbug. I'm sorry I haven't put up a video, and I didn't put up one last week, so kind of been under the weather the last few days. Anyway, I'll get to that in a second. So anyway, good news today. First, I'll do the stats. My highest weight was 353 pounds. The week prior to surgery, I lost, I think it was 8 pounds. And let's see. In total, I've lost, I think it's 56 pounds altogether. Because today, I got on the scale and I was 297. Yay! But anyway, I'm really happy about that. Yesterday, I mean, they say this messes with your head sometimes, and you know what? They're right, because yesterday, so the last few days, I haven't felt good, you know, and then I started thinking yesterday, and I actually got to crying. I was thinking, why did I do this? You know, because I had a stall for maybe 2 weeks, and I just thought, oh my God. Why did I do this? I did this and then I can't even eat. And, you know, and I'm stuck like this. And I was so upset, but it passed. I was fine in the evening, you know. I talked it over with my mom and I got calmed down. And I just, because I was feeling like a complete failure, because the last 2 or 3 days I hadn't done so well, because, let's see, Sunday, I think I was on the very fine line of becoming dehydrated. I didn't want to eat, but I was able to keep things down. And that day was just a big fat failure. But I did manage to get all my water in Sunday because I thought I was going to dehydrate, so I made it a point to drink. I don't think I ate that much that day, but I did make it a point to drink all my water. Because Saturday, even though I packed all my water, I packed, you know, snacks and stuff that I could have, because we went to the Dawes Arboretum for their Arbor Day Festival. So I packed everything with me. But I left it in the truck, and I thought, well, not that big a deal. I'll go get my snack later. But what I should have done is I should have carried my water with me anyway. And I didn't carry one bottle with me. And I should have went to the truck and got more. So, and then I had, we went to a restaurant after we left, and I had an egg omelet, because we're allowed to have eggs. But it didn't sit well with me, so I didn't eat very much. And then we're sitting there and I thought, you know, I opened my straw and I put up my water, and I ordered a decaffeinated tea, but of course she brings me decaffeinated coffee. And I put this, you know, the artificial sweetener in it. Just get me to take a drink of it. I thought, I can't drink this. Good. You know, and so then I have my, take my straw out of its package and I put it in my water, and I got the straw on my lips, and it was just touching my lips. I thought, what am I doing? I could not drink out of a straw, so I take the straw, put it over to the side, and then I think, I took a sip of my water, and I thought, what am I doing? I can't, so I pushed the water away, because you're not allowed to drink 30 minutes before you eat, right? So, I had to push all my stuff away, and, you know, so then, yeah, so it was really, really fun on Saturday at the festival, but the day after was terrible. I felt horrible. I might have been getting a stomach bug or something, but I think it might have been on the verge of dehydrating. Let me see. And then the next few days after that, I haven't got my water in all those days. Monday, I was one bottle away from it. Yesterday, I only got 2 bottles of water in. Because I had to pick up my nephew, and I thought, well, I'm not going to sit there and drink a bottle of water because I'm going to have to go to the restroom and there's no place to go, you know? So then after I got my nephew, I thought, well, I'll just go ahead and go into town and get groceries. So again, I didn't have water with me, or I would have walked around the store drinking it. But I got 2 bottles of water in yesterday. So today I'm going to have to up my water game because I'm still, you know, only got one water in today so far too. But I did go to town and stuff. But I don't really think there's too much else to tell. My Facebook page, I have a Facebook page for Sleep Bug on Facebook. And I post, you know, little updates. I post some pictures of things that I've been eating. You know, every once in a while I'll post a picture of, you know, what I'm eating. And I try to post motivational quotes and pictures and stuff like that, just so it's positive. And let me see. Tonight I will be trying a new recipe that I haven't tried before with spaghetti squash from Lisa. Her Facebook is Looking Up and Letting Go, and if I remember, I will put her link in the description box. And she did a recipe for, I think it's called Chicken Primavera, and she puts it in spaghetti squash. So I'm going to try that tonight for dinner. So tonight I, you know, after I get dinner and stuff done, I will have to either put pictures or video at the end of this video before I post it, so you can all see how it went. And I've never had spaghetti squash before, so I'm excited to try it. So my mom hasn't had it either, so she's gonna try it with me tonight. And I am seriously on the lookout for a new, it's a new water flavoring. It's the A&W root beer water flavoring packets. If you guys find any, please tell me where they're at, because everybody that I know on Facebook says, get them at the dollar store. I can't find any in the dollar stores around here. I don't know why. But, I love A&W root beer. Can't have it anymore because of the carbonation and stuff like that in it, but the water flavoring I can have. So I really want to try it and can't find it. Let's see. When my nephew's here, he works out with me. He gets my little dumbbells and does his little exercises and stuff. And it's really fun. And, next week, hopefully, I will have more good news to share. It really depends on stuff that happens this week, but I can't wait to tell you my other good news next week, hopefully. That's not scale related, so it would be considered an NSV, I do believe. And another NSV. I bought a pair of pants before I got to my highest weight, and these pants never fit. They were a size 5X, and because the biggest part on me was my belly, right? So they were a 5X, and they were so tight, I couldn't sit down in them, because if I would have, I would have busted them and tore them. Well, the other day, last week, I was cleaning my room and dusting and stuff, and I got everything out of my closet and washed it. And so all my clothes that's in the house, besides what I've got on now, it never fit me. And most of them don't right now, but they will in a couple months. And these one pants that I bought, they, They're green, and I don't know what kind of material they are, really, but it's not stretchy. But there's like a drawstring waistband in them, and they I just set up the other day. I'm gonna try those on and see how they fit. Well, when I first got them, couldn't sit down in them, and I tried them on the other day. Guess what? They are so freaking big. I have to pull them all the way up to just under my bra line and tie the drawstrings because they're so big. They'll fall down if I don't. So I was constantly having to pull them up because if I didn't, the crotch was down to my knees. So first, really, besides my coat fitting, this was the first time I've had something clothing wise that got bigger. So I'm finally starting to see it. I was starting to feel like, why did I do this? Well, because I was stalled for 2 weeks, and today I'm under 300 pounds, and I have a pair of pants that is big enough they're gonna start falling off of me if I don't get them tied. And that's never happened to me before, so I'm really excited about that. And when I was at my support group the other day, I showed my nutritionist all the stuff that I was taking for my vitamins, and my multivitamin is good. My calcium would have been okay, but I got citrate, I think, and she told me to get the other one, so that's okay. And I'll just have to switch it once I finish these, which will be in a few days. And my B12, I'm supposed to have the, what do they call it, sublingual or whatever, where it goes under your tongue. And right now I have the lozenges where you can either suck on them or chew them. And she told me that they prefer me to get the ones under the tongue. And the place where I was getting them, I couldn't find those. So she told me to go look at Walmart. So I will go there in a couple weeks and see about that. I'm almost 3 months out, and so far I don't think I've had any hair loss. At least I hope I haven't, but no more than usual anyway. So hopefully when that time comes I don't lose that much, because, but anyway, and I've had this thing on my neck. I don't know if you can see the rest of it, but down here and up through here, I don't know why, I've been very itchy through here. I don't know if it's dry skin, I don't know if it's, I'm lacking something, and, from not being able to eat much, I don't know, so I'm gonna have to find out from the doctor. Maybe it could be possible that I got some poison ivy or something too from when we went mushroom hunting, I don't know, but very itchy. That, and also, I never had nails before, and I stopped biting them after surgery because I was afraid they would get stuck in the incisions inside and cause me trouble. So, I haven't bitten my nails, and my nails are pretty long, and they used to be bit down so low they were like to the quick. I mean, I had no nail at all whatsoever. And so I've been itching and not being used to fingernails, I'm leaving marks all over myself from, the scratching, so I could get used to that. I don't know if there's anything else that I had to discuss or not. I'm not sure. But Saturday on the Arbor Day Festival, we got two little trees to take home, and we planted them out at my dad's on the hill, and my nephew named them Red, which is a cypress, and the other one he named Frank, because my aloe vera plant is named Frank, and he named his tree Frank, and I'm not really sure what type of tree Frank is, so, But I don't think there's too much else to say right now that I remember. But if I do remember, I'll let you know. So, make sure to check out the Facebook page, Sleepbug. And, you know, if you have questions or anything like that, that would probably be the best place, you know, to leave me a message there or something. If it's something you don't want to publicly say or something. Because I know sometimes if you have a question, it's hard to ask where everybody else can see it. So, yeah, you can find me there. And I guess that's it. So, yeah, I'll see everyone later, and remember to chase your butterfly. So here is our chicken squash primavera. I cut it in half before I took the picture, so yeah, it should be pretty yummy. This bigger plate will be my mom, and I got this little saucer for me, so yeah.